Let's talk about flow work and energy transfer. When we have a control volume, so a system where mass can go in and out, some work is required to push the mass into or out of the system. This work is called flow work or flow energy. In simple terms, it's the energy required to push a fluid into or out of a control volume. When a fluid is at rest, it doesn't possess any flow energy. Flow work can be found by multiplying pressure by the volume. And if we wanted to write it per unit mass, it would be like this and have the units kilojoules per kilogram. This equation is the same whether a fluid is pushed into or out of a control volume. Previously, we talked about the total energy of a system using this equation. Here, U is internal energy, KE is kinetic energy, and PE is potential energy. If we were to consider the additional form of energy we talked about, so flow energy, then the total energy of a flowing fluid can be written like this. We use theta to represent the total energy of a flowing fluid. So all we did was add the pressure times specific volume part in. Something very interesting happens when we write it like this. Remember we discussed enthalpy? Well, the equation for enthalpy was this. Notice how this part is the same. That means this part can be replaced with enthalpy like this. When we write it in terms of enthalpy, we don't need to worry about flow work, since enthalpy takes care of it. When we have mass that enters or leaves a system, the energy associated with the flowing fluid of mass can be written like this. If the mass is flowing at a certain rate, then we can write our equation like this, so rate of energy transport. Whenever kinetic energy and potential energy are negligible, then from our previous equation, these parts become zero. So energy transport equations also end up simplifying to just mass times enthalpy. Now let's get to some examples to see how we can use the equations we talked about. To solve these problems, you should keep in mind that enthalpy can be found by multiplying specific heat by the difference in temperature. Also, things like the ideal gas equation, equations relating mass flow, and density are all going to be useful. In this question, we have a house that's at 1 atm and a temperature of 24 degrees Celsius. When cold air enters the house, the warm air leaves, and we need to figure out the rate of net energy loss due to this mass transfer. Let's write down what we know. The pressure is 1 atm, or 101 kilopascals. The temperature outside is 5 degrees Celsius, the inside air is 24 degrees Celsius, and the rate at which the warm air leaves the house is 150 cubic meters per hour. We will also need the gas constant of air, which we can find from this table. And we need the specific heat of air at 24 degrees Celsius, which is 297.15 Kelvin. So that's the value right here. Now how do we figure out the energy loss? The net energy loss is the difference between the mass of energy flow that's leaving minus the mass of energy flow that's coming in. How do we figure out the energy flow that's coming in and out? We can use the energy transport equation. Now, for theta in and out, all we have is enthalpy since the potential energy and kinetic energy change is negligible. So we can write our net mass equation like this. Let's factor out the mass flow. Next, we need to figure out the enthalpy. For that, we can use this equation, so let's replace it. Now all we need to do is plug values in, but notice how we have everything we need except for mass flow. To figure out mass flow, we can use this equation. To use this equation, we need the density. For that, we can use the ideal gas equation. Since we want to find the density using this equation, we need to replace specific volume with density. Remember that density is equal to 1 over specific volume. That means specific volume is equal to 1 over density. We can replace it in our ideal gas equation like this. Let's isolate for density. Now we can plug our values in. Keep in mind that we're looking at the inside of the house, so our temperature is 24 degrees Celsius or 297.15 Kelvin. Let's solve, and that's our density. Now we can use this value to figure out the mass flow. Our answer is in kilograms per hour, so let's divide it by 3600 to get it per second. We finally got our mass flow, so let's go back to our original equation and start plugging values in. Solving gives us 0.945 kilojoules per second, or 0.945 kilowatts. Let's take a look at this problem, where we have refrigerant 134A entering a compressor. We need to figure out the rates of energy transfer for mass in and out. Let's write down what we know. The refrigerant enters at a pressure of 0.14 megapascals, leaves at 0.8 megapascals, the temperature as it leaves is 60 degrees Celsius, and the mass flow rate at which it leaves is 0.06 kilograms per second. We can find the rates of energy transfer using this equation. Since potential energy and kinetic energy are negligible, we just need to consider enthalpy, so let's replace theta with it. With the given values, we can look up the enthalpy values using a table. For the initial enthalpy, we're told that it's a saturated vapor with a pressure of 0.14 megapascals. Our value is right here. For our second enthalpy value, we're told that it's a superheated vapor with a pressure of 0.8 megapascals and a temperature of 60 degrees Celsius. So that's the value right here. Now that we have these values, we can plug them in into our equations. Those are our answers. That should cover the types of problems you will face when it comes to flow work and energy transfer by mass. Thanks for watching, and best of luck with your studies.